Hello, my name is Carrie Michael Robinson. I'm originally from Mobile, Alabama, and I currently reside in Washington, D.C. My entry in the Voices of FAMU art exhibition is entitled HOPE, and that's an acronym for Highly Optimistic and Powerfully Efficient. This painting is also the first entry of my sequential styled artwork series entitled Sathemba, Man of Tomorrow. A little bit about Sathemba. So he is a fictional superhero character who I developed based on being inspired by the Black Panther, Black Lightning, all the black superheroes. And his name, Sathemba, is a Zulu word that means hope. He takes the form of a yellow swallowtail butterfly, which also symbolizes hope. In this particular painting, Sathemba is pictured with Nefertiti, who is wearing a three-tiered crown, which is equivalent to the building design of the Smithsonian National Museum of African American History and Culture in Washington, D.C. Nefertiti is releasing Simba into the universe in hopes that he will bring about peace and justice to our nation. In the attempt to address the numerous existing and emerging social issues that our nation is facing today, it is my hope that viewers of this artwork can acquire a sense of joy and healing in the belief that our nation, particularly African Americans, will soon be relieved from excessive social injustice, domestic violence, depression, and anxiety. In regards to the materials used, I consider this to be a mixed media painting, which consists of black and white collage prints, acrylic, paint, and glitter on canvas. To see more artwork from the Sathemba Man of Tomorrow series, please visit carriemichael.com/Sathemba. If I have to recall some of my fondest memories at FAMU in the arts department, it would have to be in 2008 when myself and my fellow colleagues established the FAMU Fine Arts Society. The FAMU Fine Arts Society was essentially a student-based arts club. We noticed that the arts department did not have an art club, or the existing art club dissipated, and we wanted to just provide an environment where artists can collaborate outside of the classroom while also making a difference in the community. Because we noticed a lot of the students in the fine arts program weren't able to continue their degrees or weren't able to purchase supplies, we wanted to change this narrative. So we participated in a lot of fundraising events to raise money, such as baked goods sales, car washes, and various exhibits throughout the Tallahassee community that were aimed to raise the awareness of our program as well as raise proceeds. Some of our biggest accomplishments would have to be participating in a Black History exhibit at the Mary Brogan Museum of Art, which was featured in the local newspaper, the Tallahassee Democrat. We also were able to arrange and execute planning for a fine art showcase, which was featured in the Foster Tanner Fine Arts Gallery called Explore Your Element. This showcase featured a variety of visual and performing arts, including open mic, spoken word, live art, live body art, as well as a selection from the jazz band. While this was only a student-run organization, little did I know the Fine Arts Society was very beneficial to my career as an artist, as I am now the CEO and creative brainchild of ArtBay, which is an arts collective that is devoted to putting our art before anything else, located in the Washington, D.C. area. For more information about ArtBay, visit artbayonline.com.